Welcome to War India News Hour. Top tech companies have shown impressive growth. Top Wall Street analysts expect strong earnings results from the stocks of tech giants. Apple, Microsoft and Alphabet each reported impressively robust earnings results for the June quarter, demonstrating that these giant companies continue to go from strength to strength even as they face greater regulatory scrutiny. If there is any downside for the companies and their shareholders, it's that the results will only concentrate critics' minds about their sheer financial strength. A report shows Microsoft delivered its strongest revenue growth since 2008. Alphabet not only reported stunning revenue growth of 62%, it also kept expenses under control so well that its operating profit margin hit 31%, several percentage points above what Alphabet typically reports. Apple posted a 36% top-line increase. Every part of its business expanded. Apple, aside much of big tech surge, is being driven by advertising. That was most obviously true at Alphabet, where its YouTube video ad revenue grew 84%, but even Microsoft benefited. The software giant posted 97% growth in its LinkedIn Marketing Solutions group and a stunning 53% jump in search advertising. That's three times the March quarter growth in the search business. Alphabet's operating profit margin nearly doubled to 31% from a year earlier and up slightly from the first quarter. Since 2014, on an annual basis, the operating margin has ranged between 20% and 26%. The improvement was a result of Alphabet keeping a very tight lid on costs. But some of that might be related to a COVID-related slowdown in the costs of real estate expansion that may now be ending. At the same time, Azure, arguably now Microsoft's most important business, in previous quarters has been reliably posting revenue growth of around 50%. Whereas Microsoft's free cash flow of $16.3 billion was about the same as Alphabet's and just a little below Apple's $19 billion. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. RBI imposes Rs. 5 crores penalty on Axis Bank over rule violations. The Reserve Bank of India has imposed a penalty of Rs. 5 crores on Axis Bank for contravention of certain provisions of directions issued by the central bank, including on the cybersecurity framework. RBI reviewed the supervisory evaluations of the bank and instances of fraud and instances of suspicious transactions in June 2020. This action is based on deficiencies in regulatory compliances, RBI said. Indian Navy bans drones to fly in 3 km radius of its installations in Gujarat. The Indian Navy said on Wednesday that flying UAVs, that is unmanned aerial vehicles or drones, without prior approval in a 3 km radius of naval installations in Gujarat is not allowed. The Navy has already warned of similar action at its bases in Mumbai and Goa. The move comes in the wake of a drone attack on the Indian Air Force base in Jammu last month. It further states the Indian Navy reserves the right to confiscate or destroy any aerial drones or UAVs found flying within these areas without prior approval. Operators found violating these guidelines will be liable for prosecution under relevant provisions of law. Cyient to acquire Melbourne-based Workforce Delta. Hyderabad-based Cyient has signed an agreement to acquire Workforce Delta, a Melbourne, Australia-based workforce management consultancy. With this, Cyient will incorporate Workforce Delta into its Industry 4.0 focus solution suite, the IntelliCyient portfolio. Mobile Workforce Management, that is MWM, is an umbrella term for the tools and processes that help mobile workers with their jobs in terms of increasing productivity and efficiency. Language learning app Duolingo valued at $6.5 billion in US market debut. Language learning app Duolingo made its US stock market debut on Wednesday. The company's shares surged to a record high as 40% on listing, giving it a valuation of $6.5 billion on a fully diluted basis. The company's flotation comes at a time of increased investor interest in the edtech space after pandemic restrictions sent students and teachers from the classroom to the web. The shares opened at $141.4 apiece, up from the initial public offer price of $102 apiece. Language learning app Duolingo Inc.'s shares rose nearly 39% in their US market debut, giving the company a valuation of $6.5 billion on a fully diluted basis. Logbit ransomware can encrypt Windows domains using group policies. A group of researchers found a new strain of Logbit ransomware that automates the encrypting of Windows domains by leveraging Active Directory group policies, according to Bleeping Computer. The Logbit ransomware campaign began in September 2019 as a service-by-service ransomware scheme in which threat actors are tasked with infiltrating networks and encrypting devices. In exchange, the employed affiliates pay 70 to 80% of the total amount, with the remaining 20% going to the Logbit founders. That's it for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to VAR India News Magazine. Stay tuned. Thank you.